All right, so today we're going to talk about Blackbox Explorer as it relates to the new Betaflight 3.3.0 release. Okay, so you're on Betaflight 3.3.0 and you'd like to look at your Blackbox logs, and some things are either a little funky or it's not working out for you, they're not opening, or you're not getting the right debug mode, so on and so forth. So the primary issue with that is that you need to download the latest version of Blackbox Explorer, and it's right down here at the bottom right. It's 3.0.0. Right now it's release candidate 1 for Blackbox Explorer. So if you're getting Blackbox Explorer through the Chrome app, that's a super old version of Blackbox Explorer, and you want to get rid of that. That's no longer, it hasn't been updated like since August. So get that out of there. You're going to have to do it manually now. You're going to have to go and download the source code direct and then put it on your C drive and connect it using CleanFlight. So anyways, the one I like, there's two, and I have all the different open source code projects starred here in my GitHub account, but there's two main repositories. There's a Betaflight Blackbox Log Viewer, and there's also a CleanFlight Blackbox Log Viewer. So you'd think, oh, we'll just go to the Betaflight one. The developers for both of these, I really don't know why we have two, but there is. And ironically, they steal back and forth. I think it's really the same people. I don't follow it that closely. But at the end of the day, I find that the CleanFlight one's actually, well, it's a little cleaner. That's also version 3.0.0-RC1. Same as the Betaflight one. So my recommendation is to download the CleanFlight one. That's what I use. Works great. There's nothing really wrong with the Betaflight one. It's just the header, like when you go into the header fields thing, and I'll show you that in a minute, it has a stack of more missing header fields. It doesn't show if the dynamic filter is on or not, which is something I always look at, and the CleanFlight one does. Somebody just cleaned up that part of it a little bit more. And everything else to me looks the same between the two. So anyways, I'll put this link in the video description just so you can click on it and go ahead to that site. What you need to do is hit the download button here and go ahead and hit download zip file. Now I'm not going to go through the process of unzipping a file. There's a zip file, you open it up, there's a folder inside, you drag that folder onto your C drive somewhere that, you know, it can be stationary. Then what you need to go do is go into Chrome, go type Chrome / extensions, and that will bring up this page. At the top you need to check on developer mode, and then you have to hit load unpacked extension. You'll browse out to your computer for wherever you put that folder. So I have this thing called local, drop local, and then RC configurators. And then what I do and recommend, it's up to you, every now and then I download a newer version, but I don't like to delete the old one yet. Because the primary focus on development, honestly, is the Betaflight core code. Then the configurator comes later. And then, like, the Blackbox Explorers are kind of like the redheaded stepchild. They get attention eventually, but, you know, sometimes it just kind of lacks. There's not as much focus there, not as many people are using them. So, I'll download the later ones, but I like to keep the older ones for a little just to, you know, I grow comfortable with them. And then, anyways, it's up to you. So, when you drag this folder, it would be this name, Blackbox Log Explorer. I usually put BF in front and then the date out the back. You just click the folder itself, and then you hit OK. That will go ahead and load it. Now, you didn't really see anything happen here because it loaded what it already had. You can see it loaded this one and that one was there, so you didn't really see it. But I'll take that out for now. But that's all you do. And then after that, you can click the, if you have the toolbar up, you hit Apps, just like you did before, or APPS here, and then your new Blackbox Explorer will be there. You can right click on it, hit create shortcuts, and then it will create a shortcut in your start menu or desktop if you want as well, and then you don't have to keep opening Chrome all the time. In Blackbox Explorer, this is the CleanFlight one. This is what I was talking about with the header fields. If I click on the header fields here, and you'll see that, you know, like this needs a little cleanup. If you go down here at the very bottom, it says missing header field. So these are header, this is data in the header file, which is what displays all this stuff. It's basically let you know what the kind of setup is. And this, it doesn't understand what these are. So this has to deal with this, probably, so on and so forth. So just a coding thing that needs cleaned up. The Betaflight Black Box Explorer has a longer list. Now, if you're watching this video 6 months from now, maybe that's different. But as of at least a week ago, that was the case. I haven't downloaded it for a little bit, like a week. But okay, well, that's it. Hopefully this helps. And then from there, if you have your debug mode set to notch when you're doing a flight, when you bring that up now and you hit graph setup, you know, you'd open that log in here, you'd hit graph setup, you go to custom graph, slide down to it, and then you should see the appropriate debug mode notch. And then if you just pick this one, it will add the respective roll, pitch, yaw, and then the blank one. As a side note, if you ever get a log and you open up the debug mode equals notch, and then the graph is just spikes up and down of unusable data, just like a whole mess of data here. What the issue is, I've seen, is sometimes, see this not used one? There's some sort of glitch that, you know, it will be unusable until you go in, because you can't run a spectrograph analysis on that with all that data like that. It will be unusable until you just go in and simply just take that unused one out and then hit save, and then it will be fine. Now here, mine was fine, so it didn't matter. But another little tip there. All right, guys. Thanks. Hope this helps. Thank you.